All right, thank you for staying with us. Still sports tonight. Okay, let me just spend some time to read a few of the comments you are sending to us via Twitter. The football talker, at the football talker, football addict on Twitter says, what do you mean by alternate players? I think I explained that. Just use players on standby, four of them for the Olympic Games. And Shola Akoyejo at SK underscore musician. Says, kindly explain in details the alternate players. I seem not to understand why is Taiwo Awoniyi among the alternate players. I think we've done that. They are players on standby, not in the first 18, but placed on standby in case there are injuries before the games begin. And as you saw at the beginning of the show, we still have 15 days to the game. So anything can still happen, and any of those guys can still get in. Israel Akinlamo says it's upbeat. The team will get out of that group. He says, forget about the friendlies. He believes at the Olympic Games, the team will come good. Ayodeko Rashid says, Samson Cesar Scott is a nice one, but we will be missing Kelechi Iheanacho. God bless Nigeria. All right. That's one of it. Ola Yinka Wulewa, a very good friend from Ilorin Kwara, says, now is the best time. Nigeria is capable of winning the football gold medal at the Olympics. It is sad some of our few key players are not available. These are the reactions that are coming through on social media. Guys, very quickly, let's take a look at a few issues abroad. Let's go abroad before we go on a break and bring in Femi Adifeso. Spain have named the coach.
Yeah. Julen Lopetegui, that's his name. Surprise choice, because Joaquin Caparros was the top favorite to take this job, but the Spanish Federation have gone with Julen, who has worked with the under-19.
Yes,
won the title with them. Also won title with the under-21 too. Span the under-20 side, so he's come through the ranks. Managed FC Porto, I think, lost his job early this year, but he's got a hole on his hands because Spanish football has to regenerate. Spanish football has to start again.
And I guess that's why he's saying it's not a revolution. It's just an evolution. He believes there's nothing wrong with the players that we have in the Spanish setup. Probably just needs a little tinkering. You don't have to just break the whole team down. And, you know, he's familiar with the setup, just like Wale said. And I think that's what will come in Andy for him. Whether or not he'll be able to take Spain to the heights that Del Bosque and the others have been able to do, we'll wait to see. But the Spaniards want to get back on top as early as they can. They now see themselves as contenders for any tournaments they appear in. They go into tournaments now wanting to win. And that's a huge burden on any coach's shoulder. But then again, he seems to be happy with the crop of players that he has. And I trust he's not going to do anything drastic. If what he said today is anything to go by, this man will not do anything drastic. Probably surgical.
Change a few things.
But he's got a big decision to make. Iker Casillas.
It's not a decision.
He brought him back to FC Porto, remember? He's got a work relationship with Iker Casillas.
It's not a decision.
Is he bringing him back to the national
team? Is it
David Villa? That's not a decision.
No. I think Julen Lopetegui changes the whole thing for Iker Casillas, who probably would have been thinking that, hey, I have to leave since David Villa has taken center stage. He's worked with Julen before. And see, coaches sometimes don't work with four players. They work with players they trust. And if you trust Iker Casillas, he might bring him back.
All right. Let's leave that man to worry about all of that and face the next story. Pep Guardiola is being modest. He's now the man in charge of Manchester City, and of course we'll be working with our own Kelechi Iheanacho. He's been very modest. He says his target is to ensure that they are able to get into Champions League football.
That's what I expect him to say.
Yeah.
Of course, that will not be what.
Or remain in Champions League football.
That's not going to be in his mind. Of course, Pep Guardiola comes to a place he wants to win. And what he said, a lot of people want him to prove something. And I think he gets the opportunity to do that because he has to build a team. Manchester City have deep pockets, but somehow they've not been able to, you know, get the worth of the money, in terms of value, that they've spent. And I think Pep is the man that can do that. He's just been modest. You know, Pep, I think he's going to be up and running from the first season. And he probably would ensure that they get into the UEFA.
What about all the stories about Yaya not being involved? Look like Yaya settled in.
It's still speculative. He played yesterday against Bayern.
It's still early.
He played against Bayern, but the signs are still not clear yet. The only club interested in Yaya was Inter Milan, and there's still mixed signals in there. But remember that the player that Pep wants to really, really mash out the midfield is still out injured, Ilkay Gundogan. So Yaya will probably still be a key member, at least for now. But I think if Yaya gets a big offer from the Fires, probably from China, it will still consider it, but it still early does. The transfer window is still much open.
The history between Yaya Toure and Pep Guardiola will be a big factor that might not make
I think we're over analyzing that history between Yaya and because it didn't work out the other time. Remember that Yaya also was playing under Pep until Sergio Busquets came.
He's a coach that wants to win and a player that seems to be going past his prime. So you look at that equation. If I was in his shoes, I'd probably tell Yaya, you know, you need to look for another place to play your football.
Okay, well, you are not Pep, so let's see what Pep will do at the end of the day. But guys, before I let you go, let me just read through some of the comments coming through on Twitter. Sunday Show Yemi says, I wish the Olympic Eagles all the best in Brazil. No, it says, okay, I wish Team Nigeria all the best in Brazil, especially the Dream Team. And he says, well, Adegun, you look great.
Oh, thank you very much.
That's one for you.
Thank you very much.
Ademola Adeleye says, dreams. It will happen. What will happen? I don't understand exactly. Maybe the Dream Team winning gold. I mean, they camped in Atlanta, get inspiration from what happened 20 years ago, and then they go to Rio, and they win it right there for Nigeria. Eddie Ogbemudia, our friend who watches us regularly from Warri in Delta State, says, nice team by CR1. With the available players for the Rio 2016, it says we should please inform the NFF to provide all the kids the bonuses for the team to excel. At this stage, the team is no longer just a property of the Nigerian Football Federation. It becomes a property of the Federal Ministry of Youth and Sports. Anyway, from time, they've always been Nigeria's property, so it doesn't change too much.
They were handed over to the president a couple of years back.
I mean, right now, it's even beyond the NFF. So the funding, everything they need, should come direct now from the Federal Ministry of Youth and Sports. And of course, watch out, we've been told that they're going to be using brand new Nike kits at the Olympic Games. So they are going to be launching it.
So the new one.
The new design. They will be launching it at the Olympic Games. So there's something for us to look forward to. Guys, thank you so much for your time.
It was a pleasure.
On Sports Tonight, Wale, really looking great.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah, and of course, I must also say that Yemi Adebayo is also looking great. All right, we'll go on a quick break now. When we return from this break, Femi Adefeso will be coming in and he will be talking basketball. What's happening in the camp of the D-Tigers? He spent his whole day talking to those guys on phone. And he will be here to tell us all that is going on in the camp. And, of course, the build-up to Rio 2016. Join us again. All right, thank you for staying with us. It's time for us to move on to the final part of Sports Tonight. And the last part of the show, of course, is reserved for Mr. Femi Adefeso. And we'll be talking basketball on Sports Tonight. Femi, good to have you on Sports Tonight.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Once again. Thank you. What's going on? Yesterday, we lost by 20 points.
More than that. After 101-79. That was a huge margin.
Almost 20 points.
Yes, a huge margin.
22 points.
Yes, it was even up until the late in the third quarter. Before the Argentines
pulled away.
It's not all sad. Looking at the scores.
Yeah, the coach was not thinking about the result, as I said.
Yes.
He was looking at his roster and how he's going to be managing his squad of 12.
Exactly. And at everything. The end of the day, just 16 people in camp. You know, 15, excluding the captain, who we'll be talking about, before we run out of the studio. And tomorrow, well, mind you, is the deadline that FIBA set, you know,
for you to release your list of 12.
So, and what he did was to rest about 5 players, you know, in that game. I could tell authoritatively that Mike Biniji didn't play, you know, he destroyed Pistons man. So also did Al-Farouk, you know, Jamal Olaseyere, Sulaimon also wasn't, you know, in the squad that played, you know, that the second game against Argentina. So it ended up even 1-1. Also, Argentina also deployed the same tactics. You know, not the whole set of players that played, you know, the first game, play the second game. There were also about 6 changes, you know, in their own roster as well. So
let's talk about the big one. Olumide pulling out of the team. Family reasons, personal reasons, some reasons.
Exactly. And those reasons, I think it would be nice if he can
share some personal reasons.
Because his withdrawal has, you know, taken, you know, a lot of reactions, you know, from in different dimensions, you know, from people. He released that, you know, on his youth foundation, you know, page, you know, for yesterday morning. You know, he woke me up. You know, when someone just called me and asked me, tell me this is true or this is a lie.
Mm.
You know, and I was like,
almost 20 years of service.
Yes, you know, he started playing from mid of 96. I mean, in the year 96, beg your pardon. And he was part of the 97, you know, squad that went to Senegal, you know, there back then. Now that's a long time. Masai Ojiri was in that squad. It goes to show how long, you know, that has been. And all through, you know, Olumide Odeji has been a journeyman. You know, he's represented, you know, Nigeria at 9, you know, Nations Cup events, 5 All African Games. He's managed, you know, to win, of course, a gold medal, you know, which we won, you know, last year in 2015, and the All African Games in 2011. We won bronze twice at the Nations Cup, by the way, and he was also part of that squad in 2005 in Algeria and in 2011, you know, in Madagascar. Olumide has served, you know, all through there. Also, in case you didn't know, he's a member of the Nigerian Basketball Federation, you know, as a board member, and also is a player's representative as well on the FIBA, you know, that is International Basketball Federation, you know, commission. So he's someone who has played his part both on the court and off it. But he's such a close time to the Rio Olympics, and one would have felt, okay, we know it's his last dance. You know, maybe he should have just, you know, gone there and probably just, you know, said his goodbyes, you know, to the game, you know, in a more professional way. But I don't know why he has taken this decision. Plenty of people have come with side comments here and there. Maybe he felt he was not going to make the squad. Maybe he was actually tired. You know, his legs, you know, were beginning to tell him, like, look, I think it's about time you go off and just take the back seat. You know, it's very difficult. But I wish we can actually really, really get to, you know, to examine exactly, you know, what really is on his mind, you know, why he has gone out. But all the same, I think what he has given to the game cannot be robbed of.
All right, we'll go on a quick break now. We'll still talk basketball when we return. But then when we return, we'll be spending the rest of the time to focus more on preparations for the Olympic Games by the Tigers and a lot more after this timeout. Join us again. All right, thank you for staying with us. This is the final part of the show. We have very few minutes left. But enough for us to still talk basketball, and this time focus on Africa's only representatives at the Rio Olympics. That's the Tigers of Nigeria.
Yes.
That's huge. Big responsibility for us. So what's going on with the team right now? After these games against Argentina, there's still a game.
Two more games. They will play China
and the American B team.
Yes, the main Olympic team.
The American Olympic team.
Yes. Okay. So what it is that they've been in Las Vegas for the past 1 week. But this night, I can tell you that they will be going back, you know, to Los Angeles, where they actually set camp, you know, from the onset. So they would play China, you know, just before they now fly to Houston, where they play that game. That game against China should be on Wednesday, and if I'm not mistaken, Wednesday or Tuesday, depending on the time, you know, zone it will fall into. And then we'll now play the U.S. national team going to the Olympic Games on August the 1st, you know, in Houston. That will be the last game, you know, before we go, you know, to Rio de Janeiro. And I'm just glad that at least with all the lack of preparation from the contingent of Nigeria, at least some few sports have been able to put, you know, themselves in a good position. So at least win something. You know, it's going to be a very huge task, you know, for the D-Tigers going into Rio. But they've played Argentina, who they'll be playing, you know, in the group. So at least they have a foreknowledge, you know, of the team, of what to expect. They'll be playing the USA, the best team, you know, in basketball today. You know, also, you can't come any bigger when you have the likes of Spain, Brazil, Argentina, Lithuania, you know, Croatia, you know, all up in your group. If you're able to test your power against these ones and you can survive, at least to the very least, we played 1-1, you know, with Argentina. We lost one, we won one. Mm. You know, we're going to play China again for the fourth time. You know,
we've beaten them
three times. By the way, China, you know, is in the top five teams, you know, in the world. So it's not like we are playing some minnows or people who don't know how to play basketball. So if I've been able to hold our own against those kind of teams, and then we play the U.S. national team, regardless of whether I win or not, I think it's good preparation. So I wish them all the best. Hopefully, something can come out.
All right. That's how we have to wrap it up on Sports Tonight. It's Thursday. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again tomorrow. Bye-bye now.